the Rise of Skywalker coming out, I wanted to finally make a video tutorial using Filmora to show you how you can use the powers of the Force. Today I'm going to show you how to crush a can. I should have shown you how to shave. So the first thing I did was I actually set up my shot. I can't stress this enough. The most important thing is understanding what it is you think your shot needs to look like and then arranging it beforehand so that you're not just filming a bunch of stuff and hoping it comes together. So I set up this very low angle shot across a table with the camera focused in on this aluminum can. So there's the can and the camera is focused on the can. I'll just scrub through quickly. You can see I took position here and I made sure I stayed to one side. I knew that I was gonna split this film somewhere between myself and the can. And the first thing I did is I took a couple of passes thinking, what might it look like if I was gonna reach out, use the Force, and crush the can? And you can see a couple different ways here that I tried doing it. Closing my fist, holding it vertically, horizontally. And I just did it at different speeds too because I didn't know which one would make the most sense. So that's the first part with me reaching out, acting like I'm using the Force. And the can is just there front and center with the camera focused on it. I then went around to the side and came back to that can. I reached over and I crushed the can a little bit. And I tried as hard as I could not to move that can. I really wanted it to stay in the same position. But not only that, I made sure I pulled my body back enough that me being anywhere near the shot didn't affect the lighting, didn't affect the reflections in the can, because you would see it as this thing crushed down. I then reached in and I gave it another slight crush. And I did the exact same thing. I just walked away a little bit and I let that exposure and ISO settings close in to what I had set for me in the background. And I did this in stages. I just kept reaching in and grabbing the can and trying not to wrinkle the tablecloth and then get everything to sit perfectly. And I did probably 5 or 6 different crushes where I reached in, crushed the can, and then moved away. And that was my final shot with the can completely crushed down. Now, once I had that put together, I went back. I picked the Force movement that I wanted to use. I'll split that here. I'll get rid of the beginning. Now, I'm going to take that intro section and I'm going to slide it up into another track. Now, let me go over to where I did the can crushing motion. I want to first find a point where the can is just sitting by itself. And I'm going to split my footage right there. Now I want to stretch my footage out so that I can really see this frame by frame, because I'm going to steal a few frames from here. Let's left click and hold and stretch this footage out, dragging the timeline out so that we can really get this down to frame by frame. And I just want one frame of this can sitting there. So I'll move one frame ahead. I'm going to slice that footage again. And that's the piece that I want to keep. I can actually lose the piece before it. I'll delete that. And then I'm going to move forward and find the next crush position. This is kind of like a stop motion animation where you're making a slight adjustment in what's in front of you, taking one still frame and then moving ahead, changing it slightly, and then taking basically another photograph. But because I was actually filming the video, I'm finding those sections in those individual frames that will make it feel like a stop motion animation. All right, I make the next brush. I move away, I let the camera adjust, and I'm gonna split it again right here. Let me stretch this out. I just wanna steal one frame, I'll move one frame forward, I'll slice that again, and now I can delete the section in between. I'm gonna put the auto ripple on, and it'll remove the space when I delete this section. Now let's move forward to where we have the next crush section. Here's another crush that I made. The camera lighting has adjusted. I'm gonna stretch that footage out all the way so that I can see individual frames, move one frame forward, and I'm gonna slice that again. And now I'm gonna lose that middle piece in between, and let's move forward to the next can crush section. Let's slice that footage. I'm gonna take one frame, slice again, delete the piece in between because we don't need that anymore. Let me find the next and what I think is the final can crush. Let me slice that. Let me stretch this footage out. Let me move one frame forward, add one more slice, and lose that footage in between. Now, if you see what I've got here is these individual frames that you will see will make it look like, let me scroll through this, you can see this can crushing down. It's not perfect, and we're going to make some adjustments to that, but you can see that can crush down. Now, here's how we put these together, and I'm going to show you this a little differently than I have in the past. Sometimes we've used masking features to apply a mask over one section and split the footage, but I'm going to show you another way to do it as well. So here's what we have. The footage on top is me doing the motion, and the footage below are those frames of the can being crushed. I'm going to select all of these in the bottom and move them over. I'll turn off the auto ripple, and I'll left click and hold and slide all these over. What I'm going to try to do is line up these segments so that when I close my hand, the can begins to crush. Let me find it in here. It's right about there. Now, what I can do is I can actually add a marker so I know where I'm bringing these pieces to. And to do that, just up under the preview window, you see this little marker sign? If I click on that, it'll put a marker right in this timeline. I don't need to use any of the labeling for right now. I'm just using it as a reference point of where to bring this footage to. And I'm gonna try to bring these so they all start right over about the beginning of that marker. Now you can't see the can crushing because I have the full frame of me doing my force maneuver on top, but let's fix that. And we'll do this without a mask. Watch, let's left click on the footage. Let's choose crop and zoom. And in the crop window, what I want you to do is click on the ratio and choose custom. Now we're not gonna change the height, but we're gonna change the width of this piece. Let's grab the right side of this because that's how I set this up. I'm on the left. I'm gonna grab the right side, left click and hold, and drag this over just to the other side of that can. And I'm going to click OK. Now, if you notice, it's now recentered me back into the frame. That's not where I wanna be. So I'm going to left click up in the preview window, and I'm gonna slide this over so that it lines up with the left. So now you'll see it's that original footage of me making the force motion with nothing on the right, but where this can footage comes in, you can see it crushing down. Now, one of the problems we have right here is on this section before the can crushes, it's black. So the way we're gonna solve that is I'm gonna turn off the main footage. I'm gonna come over to just this can shot, the full can shot that I have right there. And I'm going to take a snapshot of that particular segment. And I can do that by just clicking on the camera icon underneath the preview window. I can left click on that, bring it down into my timeline, into the bottom section, and I'm gonna put that starting from the beginning and stretch it out all the way to the point where it meets the can crush. So now when I turn the other footage back on, it'll look like I'm sitting there with that can, but this is actually half of the shot, which is just a still image of the can on the right. And as I move my hand and crush it, you'll see the can crushes down. Now there's a few things I did in here that I want you to be aware of. If you look at it, I can actually see some of the lighting is different in the frames, and that's important that you want to make sure that you can't see these two being separate images. You want them to blend together. This one here, I can see the line. Can you see how it's separated? So there's a few things that we can do here. We can click on that frame. We can go up in the upper left and choose color, and we can adjust that frame a little bit. It seems a little brighter. Let's back the brightness off just a touch. Maybe around -7 or so is a little bit closer so you don't see that line as much. And in this final section, bringing up the contrast seemed to help on the last one. Let's try a similar thing. I'm looking at the background now, maybe around 13. Maybe some of the brightness can be played with to get it to blend a little bit better. Now you can tweak these a bit and get them perfect. In my final version, I actually removed a couple of frames to get it even shorter, but you can see right here what happens. The can is just sort of sitting here, and when I crush my hand, that stop motion animation happens. And it seems like I just crushed that can. Now I use things like layered audio effects and dramatic music to really help sell this effect. And I'm gonna cover that in another video. But go ahead and try this yourself and let me know how it works out. And don't forget to click on this video over here to learn more Filmora tips, tricks, and techniques. Peace.